In this lecture, we will see the conductivity and charge carrier concentration in intrinsic semiconductor. We know that semiconductors are of two types. That is, one is pure or intrinsic semiconductor. And what is this intrinsic semiconductor? Where no impurity is added to change its property. And the second type of semiconductor is extrinsic or undoped where impurity is added to improve its property. So we know that all semiconductors behave as insulator at 0 Kelvin, but as we increase the temperature above 0 Kelvin, some electrons get sufficient energy and jump to conduction band, leaving behind a hole in valence band, and in this way the conductivity of a semiconductor will increase. And from here we can notice that the number of the charge carrier depends upon the temperature. So first let's make a calculation of this charge carrier, that is carrier concentration in intrinsic semiconductor. First we are taking intrinsic semiconductor, then we will move on extrinsic semiconductor. So we know that concentration of holes where is hole in valence band and electrons in conduction band can be obtained from the knowledge of the density of state in the valence band and conduction band. So to know the concentration of holes and electrons in a semiconductor, first we have to know the density of states or available states in valence band and conduction band. So first let me calculate the electron concentration in conduction band. So under thermal equilibrium condition, the number of electrons per unit energy or per unit volume having energy dE about E and this is the range having energy, and we can write it as having energy in a range dE about E is, so as I said earlier, to know the carrier concentration we have to know the density of states. So here we can write number of electrons about energy E in the range dE, which is equal to dE, that is density of state in the range dE, and here we have to multiply by Fermi distribution function, where dE is the density of states and FE is the Fermi distribution function. By using this formula DE, we can get the total number of available states in this range DE. But by multiplying this Fermi distribution function, we can get actual number of electrons present in these states. So, and as I calculated earlier, the value of this DE is equal to 4 pi h cube 2m raised to the power 3/2, and what is the value of this Fermi distribution function? We know that Fermi distribution function is 1/1 plus exponential
CF is the Fermi level in the inductor. This one into dE. So here we have to put the value of this E, and we can put this value by considering this concept. Let's say this is conduction band, this is valence band, and this is EF, the Fermi level. So let's say we are considering an electron at this level with energy E. Then this energy E, if EC is the energy of the minimum level in conduction band, then this energy E would be EC plus its kinetic energy, h cross square k square by 2m. So from here its energy, this energy would be h cross square k square by 2m E minus EC. So we have to put this value here and also here. So we can write this above equation as N E D E, which is equal to 4 pi h cube 2m 3 by 2 E minus E C power half into 1 plus exponential E minus E F by K T and D E. We have to also put this value here, but I am not putting at this time. So we can solve this equation by using some assumption that since E minus E C larger than K T, so we can put some assumption by putting E minus EC equal to X, and then we solve this. So finally the total number of electrons per unit volume in the conduction band is, so this number is the number of electrons present in this range dE, but we want to know the number of electrons present in conduction band. So for this we have to integrate this equation, that is NE dE, and we have to integrate this energy from EC, that is from the lower of the conduction band and to the infinity. So which is equal to dE FE or D. So by putting the value above this value here and by considering various assumption, we can solve this equation, and after solving this equation we can get N equal to 2 over 2 into 2 pi mn star kT by h square into 3 by 2 exponential minus EC minus EF by KT. So this is the number of electrons present in conduction band. And please try to solve this equation. You can see solution of this equation in SOPLIU and other books. You have to make some assumption for solving this equation, and you have to also use gamma function to solve this equation. And if we put this factor 2 into 2 pi mn star kT by h square into 3 by 2 equal to nc, because we have to write many times this equation, so simply we put instead of this to this number nc, and here mn star is the effective mass of electron. So finally we get a number that is n equal to nc exponential minus ec, so ec minus ef by kT. So this is the number of electrons at temperature T in an intrinsic semiconductor. And for silicon, this number nc is equal to 2.8 into 10 to the power 25 t by 300 3 by 2 meter cube. So we can see that this number nc varies with temperature. So now in a similar way we can get the value of holes in valence band, that is the hole concentration in the valence band. So similar to the above equation, we can get here the number of P, and we know that all holes can be represented by P, that is NP exponential. Here we have to change this. Now since EF is greater than EV, so we can use this by kT. Here we have to consider this concept that, let's say it's conduction band, we don't need now this conduction band this time, we only need this valence band. So this is the Fermi level and this is the maximum energy in valence band. So from here, if we take any value of hole, that is let's say it's at energy E, then this energy E would be equal to EV minus h square e square by 2m. For electron, we make here plus sign and here EC, but here since now EV is greater than this energy, so we have to write this in this way. By putting all this value, then we can get this number. And in above equation, NP equal to 2 into 2 pi mp star kT by h square 3 by 2, where mp star is the effective mass of holes. So for silicon np is equal to 2.8 into 10 to the power 25 t by 300 3 by 2 per meter cube. So here we calculated the value of electrons in conduction band and holes in valence band. So now let's see where is the Fermi level in intrinsic semiconductor. That is Fermi level in intrinsic semiconductor . So in intrinsic semiconductor we know that number of electron is equal to the number of holes. So from above equation we can write here Nc exponential, that is I am now going to put the value of N and P exponential minus Ec minus Ef by kT and NP exponential minus Ef minus EV by KT. So from here we can write NP by NC, which is exponential 2EF minus EC minus EV by KT. And by solving it further we can get 2EF minus EC minus EV by KT, which is equal to log natural NP NC by taking natural logarithm on both sides. We got this equation, and so from here we can write EF, which is equal to EC plus EV by 2 plus KT by 2 log natural NP by NC. Now by putting the value of this NP and NC we can get EF, which is equal to EC plus EV by 2 plus KT by 2 log natural 2 into 2 pi MP star KT H square 3 by 2 by H square we can write here into H square 2 pi mn star kT 3 by 2. So we can cancel many of these, and finally we get EF, which is equal to EC plus EV by 2 plus KT by 2 log natural MP star MN star into raised to the power 3 by 2. So this is the value of Fermi energy here. And again we can solve for this by putting this to here, because it's a logarithm. So EF equal to EC plus EV by 2 plus 3 by 4 KT log natural MP star MN star. So this is the value where Fermi level is present in intrinsic semiconductor. At we can see from here, at 0 Kelvin temperature, that is at equal to 0, this term will be 0. So EF will be EC plus EV by 2. So this is the Fermi level at 0 Kelvin temperature, and we can see here that is Fermi level is between the valence band and conduction band. So from here we can take some points or note some point, that is first one, Fermi level lies in the middle of the conduction band and the valence band. At 0 Kelvin temperature. And the second point is this is also true for all temperature provided that MP, that is effective mass of holes and effective mass of electron. So not even at 0 Kelvin temperature, the Fermi level in intrinsic semiconductors lies in the middle of the valence band and conduction band. At high temperature, at every temperature, but condition is that the effective mass of holes should be equal to effective mass of electrons. But in general, effective mass of hole is greater than effective mass of electrons. So the Fermi level is raised slightly as T exceeds 0 Kelvin, and for silicon at 300 Kelvin, the Fermi level raised only 0.01 electron volt, which may be neglected for all practical purpose. So practically we can use Fermi level in between the conduction band and valence band at all temperature for intrinsic semiconductor. So now let's see what is law of mass action in intrinsic semiconductor. This is very important to solve the number of electrons and holes at various temperature. So we know that N equal to P, or number of electrons, is equal to number of holes in an intrinsic semiconductor. And we can consider it's equal to Ni. So we can write product of N and P equal to Ni square, which is equal to Np Nc exponential Ec minus Ev by kT. I am putting the value of N and P here, and which is equal to NP NC exponential minus EZ by KT. And we know that what is EZ, let's say its conduction band, its valence band, and this difference is EZ, which is EC minus EV. So if we put value of NP and NC here, that is on putting the values of NP and NC, we can get Ni square or NP, which is equal to 4 2 pi m, we can omit from here, 2 pi kT by h square into 3, then mp star into mn star raised to the power 3/2 exponential Eg by At. So now we get a number Ni square over Np, that is this one. So from here we can write Ni equal to Np. We can write in Np or Nc, which is equal to exponential minus Eg by KT. So this is the Ni, and in another way we can also write this one as, and this is under the root, since here this Ni square. So in a simple manner we can write Ni equal to under root Np Nc, and we can write here under root in this way, which is minus half Eg by KT. So this is the N or P or Ni in intrinsic semiconductor. So from here we can note that law of mass action tells that the product of electrons and holes is a constant at a given temperature. So Ni is the product of electron and holes. Then we can see from here that this number is constant, that depends on the K T, or at a particular temperature the number of the product of the electron and holes will remain constant. And in a short way we can write that is Np, which is equal to constant at given temperature. It's a very important point to note. And the second one, if impurity atoms are added to a semiconductor or intrinsic semiconductor to increase N there will be corresponding decrease in P such that product remains constant. So in semiconductor the product of N and P is always remains constant. If we increase the number of N, then number of P will automatically decrease, and on the other hand if we increase the number of P, then the number of electrons will automatically decrease. So in this way we can say that Np, which is equal to Ni square, will remain always same in a semiconductor. So Now we know the number of electrons and number of holes in a semiconductor. So it's time to know the variation of conductivity with temperature. That is variation of conductivity with temperature in an intrinsic semiconductor. So we know that the total conductivity in a semiconductor is equal to the sum of the conductivity due to electron and conductivity due to holes. And we know that what is the conductivity due to electron, which is equal to Ne mu n, and what is the conductivity of hole, which is equal to Pe mu p, where mu n is the conductivity due to electrons, mu p is the conductivity due to holes, mu n is the mobility of electrons, and mu p is the mobility of holes. So we can write here that is total conductivity mu, which is equal to E n mu n plus P mu p. But in an intrinsic semiconductor, we know that n equal to p, and which is equal to ni. So we can write here that is E ni, which is equal to mu n plus mu p. So in this equation, that is total conductivity of semiconductor is equal to E n I mu n plus mu p. So from this equation, if we can see that if mobility does not depend on temperature, then variation in conductivity by changing the temperature is only due to change in carrier concentration. Carrier concentration Ni. Since in the above equation, we can see this conductivity depends on this number Ni and mu n and mu p. If mu mobility is constant or doesn't depend on temperature, then we can see that this conductivity only depends upon this number Ni, that is the number of charge carriers. So as I calculated earlier, Here I am directly writing the value of Ni, which is equal to 2 into 2 pi kT 3 by 2 h cube into mn star mp star 3 by 4 exponentially minus eg by 2 kT, where eg is the band gap, as I said earlier. So by putting this value in earlier equation, that is for conductivity, we can get conductivity, which is equal to E mu n plus mu p into 2 pi kT 3 by 2 h cube mn star mp star into 3 by 2 exponential minus eg by 2 kT. So I'm taking logarithm on both sides. We can get log natural, which is equal to minus eg by 2 kT, or we can write in a different way, 1 by t plus 3 by 2 log natural t plus constant. All these terms, that is 2 pi h cube mn star mp star, are constant. So I am putting all these constant in a single term, that is constant. So from here we can see that this equation is an equation of straight line. So plot of log natural conductivity and 1 by t gives a straight line. So if we plot this, that is 1 by t in this direction and log natural conductivity in this direction, then we get a graph like this, which is a straight line. So slope of this line gives an estimate of the band gap of semiconductor. In above equation, we can easily see that This is the equation of a straight line, that is y is equal to mx plus c, and m is the slope. So here, what is the slope? Slope is easy by 2k. So if we get a slope of this equation, then that the value of slope can give us the value of band gap. So in this plot, we can see that as we increase the temperature, that is, it's this scale is 1 by T, so temperature will increase in this direction. So as we increase the temperature, conductivity of the semiconductor is also increasing. So this is for intrinsic semiconductor. And one thing here we can note, that for any semiconductor, in semiconductor, the actual value of current is due to the following two consequences. That is, we use this concept in many times. So the actual current in a semiconductor depends upon the following two reasons. That is, first is due to drift current, so this is the current due to or drift of charge carrier. Under the effect of applied electric field, and second one is due to diffusion current. Diffusion current. And this is due to diffusion of carriers. Effect of concentration gradient of dopants present inside the semiconductor. So in semiconductor, the total current is always due to the drift current and diffusion current. So in next lecture, we will see the carrier concentration and conductivity in extrinsic semiconductor.